Hi all, electrical engineer Igor Yekimov is with you. Today we will look at the classic multimeter from FNIRSI S1. The device allows you to measure DC and AC voltage, resistance, capacitance, frequency and temperature. It allows you to check diodes, phase presence, and also has the functions of continuity and non-contact determination of the presence of alternating voltage. The device has a large color display with large numbers, three control buttons and a power button. The device is narrow in thickness, about 1.5 centimeters, so it fits well in a pocket. There are ribs along the edges of the case so that the device does not slip out of your hands. The design of the device itself is pleasant, black body with a blue frame. The interface of the device is intuitive, and any master can understand it. What it doesn't have is electrical current measurement capabilities. The device appeared at the beginning of 2023, and has an excellent rating on the Aliexpress platform. Aliexpress platform. For fans of FNIRSI devices, I made a detailed video review. You will find a link to the device in the description. If you are interested in device reviews, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. On top of the device there is a Type-C connector through which the device is charged. There is also a power button here, and under it there is a sensor for contactless detection of alternating voltage. The probe connectors are located here. This is the COM connector for the black probe, and this input connector is for the red one. Colors are not marked. At the bottom there is a window for a flashlight, and here you can insert a cord and hang the device. Quite a large high-resolution color display. The display is very good from different angles. The update rate is 3 times per second. There is a protective film here, which I will not remove for now. Let's briefly go through the functions of the buttons. This button only turns the power on and off. The middle button is used to switch measurement modes. We'll talk about her later. Right button. Short press to enable hold mode. With its help, we can remember the value and look at it by disconnecting the probes from the circuit being measured. Pressing again turns off the freezing mode. Long press. Turn on the flashlight. The flashlight is not very bright, but it will help. If the lighting of the circuit being measured is weak, hold again. Turn off the flashlight. The left button turns on the non-contact mode for detecting the presence of alternating voltage. And the phase detection mode. We'll talk about her later. The device came in such a beautiful box. There is a user manual on the back. This device, in this packaging, can be presented for a birthday or other holiday to a person who is interested in technology. Open the box. At the top, there are instructions in several languages. It contains Russian language. The instructions briefly describe how to use the device. But I think that after this video, you will only need these instructions to look at the characteristics of the device. And here is the device itself. Foamed polyethylene protects the device during shipment. The device was in a package that I had already removed. We take out the device along with the seal. At the bottom are the probes of the device. The probes of the device are quite soft. There are plugs on both sides to prevent the probes from oxidizing during storage. Please note that the probes have a golden coating, which also protects them from oxidation. Here is a Type-C cord for connecting the device to any 5-volt USB port for charging. The device has a 1000 mAh battery. The kit includes a thermocouple for measuring temperature. There is also a yellow square here, a kind of quality control department sign from FNIRSI. Turn on the device by pressing the power button. The device was tested and turned on auto mode. It can measure direct and alternating voltage, resistance, and also work in continuity mode. The device itself decides which measurement mode to turn on. The disadvantage of this mode is that the device needs time to determine in which mode to operate. And this is why I don't like the auto mode, and I usually don't use it. More professional is to select the measurement mode manually. But in this device, the auto mode is still useful, since only in it can resistance be measured. I'll tell you about this later. Press the left button and go to the non-contact voltage detection mode. So I bring him closer to the outlet, and he begins to feel an alternating electric field. And the device beeps. The greater the electric field, the larger this scale will be displayed, and the more often the signal will sound. This function allows you to check whether a wire or device is under 220 volts AC voltage or not before making repairs. I don't recommend looking for wiring in the wall like this. There are specialized devices for this. Press again and go to phase detection mode. To work in this mode, connect the red probe. We check at this terminal. There is a signal here, which means we have a phase here. We check at the other terminal. There is no signal here, so we have zero here. Press again and switch to auto mode. Press the middle button. The device switches to DC voltage measurement mode. In this mode, the device measures voltage up to 1000 volts. We connect both probes to the device. Let's measure the voltage on the battery, 9.85 volts. Press the hold button. Now we can disconnect the probes and the voltage value is displayed on the screen. Press hold again and this value is reset. Please note that this device does not have manual adjustment of measurement limits. Only automatic determination in all operating modes of the device. We can verify the readings are correct with another device that I usually use. The readings are approximately the same, the difference is only 0.02 volts. Press the button again. The device switches to the mode for measuring the RMS value of alternating voltage. The device measures voltage up to 1000 volts. We see interference on the probes of the device. Now we close it. There is no interference and the device shows zero readings. Let's measure the voltage in the outlet. We connect to the outlet. Ours shows 234 volts and a network frequency of 50 Hz. So I connected both devices to the outlet. The instrument readings are approximately the same. The difference is half a volt. Don't forget, when measuring high voltages, you should follow safety precautions. You should also avoid exposure to magnetic fields on the device and wires. I had the device incorrectly detect the voltage in the outlet when it was next to the monitor. Instead of 220 volts, it showed 10 volts. But when the distance to the monitor became more than 20 centimeters, the device began to show the network voltage stably. Take this into account when measuring. Press again and go to dialing mode. In dialing mode, the device works quite quickly. The buzzer sounds if the circuit resistance is less than 50 ohms. After about a second, the resistance of this circuit is displayed if it is less than 100 ohms. The device operates decently in dialing mode. Press again and go to diode test mode. Let's check the blue LED as it requires maximum voltage to light it up. Let's connect. The LED glows brightly and shows the voltage at the PN junction of 2.58 volts. Let's turn the LED around. The device shows OL, which means that we turned it on in the opposite direction. That is, using the device we can check the integrity of the diode, the forward voltage at the PN junction and its pinout. Press the button again and go to the capacitance measurement mode. Let's measure the capacitance of a 330 nanofarad ceramic capacitor. We reset the possible charge. Let's connect. 329 nanofarads is a good result. Now let's measure the capacitance of an electrolytic capacitor with a nominal value of 47 microfarads. We reset the possible charge. We connect. Taking into account the polarity. 49.3 microfarads. At the same time, he thought a little about what is normal for large capacitors. That is, the capacitance of the capacitor turned out to be slightly higher than stated, and this is good. It's worse if the readings are much lower. This would mean that the electrolyte in the capacitor has dried out and it's time to throw it away. Press again and switch to frequency measurement mode. Here I am holding the probe, and the device shows 50 Hz. This is the frequency of pickup on the probe of the device. This corresponds to the voltage frequency in the network, which means the readings are correct. The device measures frequencies up to 10 MHz. To obtain correct readings, the amplitude of the input signal must exceed 1.5 volts. But, nevertheless, the voltage at the input of the device should not exceed 250 volts. This voltage limitation also applies to other operating modes of the device, except for voltage measurement. The device has protection against high input voltages in these modes. Frequency measurement is rarely used in electrical engineering, and I will not dwell on it. Press the button again and switch to temperature measurement mode. The temperature is shown at the top in degrees Celsius, at the bottom, in Fahrenheit. Now the device measures the temperature with an internal sensor, but I do not trust the internal sensor, since its readings take into account the heating of the internal board of the device. So I connected the thermocouple. As you can see, the device shows a temperature 1 degree lower than what the internal sensor showed. So we can heat it with our hand, and it shows 34 degrees. Let's heat it up with a lighter. As you can see, the temperature has risen sharply. The device allows you to measure temperature using a thermocouple from -20 to 1000 degrees. Press the button again and go back to auto mode. This is our thermocouple that is turned on, which we will now turn off. Thermocouple resistance is 12 ohms. Although I do not like this mode, it is the only mode in this device in which you can measure resistance. Since the mode is automatic, the reading is made with a delay. Here I take a resistance of 1 ohm. We measure 995 ohms, which is within tolerance. Here the resistance is 10 ohm. We measure 10 ohm. Let's measure another 220 ohm. The same thing, the device showed 220 ohm, which is correct. You can see the instrument's error for all types of measurements in its characteristics. They are in the description of the device, and you can view them using the link in the description. There is an auto shutdown icon here. There is no information about this function in the passport, but I tested this device. The device turned off 10 minutes after the last key press. By trial, I found out that if you press the left key and turn on the device, this function is disabled. The sound signal in this device does not turn off. To disassemble the device, you need to unscrew the four screws and unfasten the latches. The latches are quite powerful, and I will not open the device using radical methods. Let's summarize. Quite a nice looking device. It has basic functions for measurement, in addition to current measurement. Good color display. Navigation through the device is clear and operation is simple. Rechargeable power allows you to use the device without purchasing batteries. Personally, I miss manual control of measurement ranges, which can be used to more flexibly obtain instrument readings. There is also a lack of a case in which to store the device and go with it to sites. I'll keep the box and walk around with it for the first time. It is also convenient that the device is thin and easy to carry in your pocket. The flashlight function allows you to work with the device in the dark. Leave your impressions about this device in the comments. If you have any questions about the device, also write in the comments. You can ask your device supplier. You will find the link in the description. Share the video with those who might be interested in such a device. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Like, and see you in new and old videos.